Hi there! You've already read the title, so you know what this video is gonna be about. Tips for using budget tripods. Instead of using the standard one elastic band technique for panning and tilting your tripod, you can use two. It's much, much easier if you have to pan tilt. You can get some counterweight on it and that's much easier. Tip number two, weight down. A budget tripod is much less sturdy than a really expensive, for example, Manfrotto or Benro, so it's much easier to just weigh it down. It's really hard to keep it stationary if you don't do it, and if you weigh it down with something, it's much easier to pan and tilt without any movement in the chassis at all. Tip number three, use it as a monopod. Luckily, just because it's a budget tripod, it doesn't mean it's useless. You can still use it as a monopod if you like. The only thing you would have to do is fold the legs together and extend or retract them so they fit your height. It's really smart, then you could just do like this. Oh, and if you were wondering about my sunglasses, it's because I really need to read the script and it's just beneath the camera. If I don't wear my sunglasses, then you can see that I'm just looking at the script and reading aloud from it. But if I have the sunglasses on, you can see if I'm looking at the lens or that lens beneath it, or the lamp, or at the microphone just above the lens. Tip number four, use the right height. If you're filming yourself like I am right now, and you want your footage to look as natural as possible, then adjust the height of your tripod until the camera is about the same height as your head. Don't film yourself from high or low angles unless you want to give the effect that you're either small or big. But if neither of those are your intention, then just put the camera at the same height of your head, and then it'll look the most natural. I know that this one didn't just refer to budget tripods, but it still matters. Tip number five. Don't talk it down like I just did. Budget tripods isn't actually that bad. It's still a huge, huge step up from just doing everything handheld, and everything can look so much more professional, and it's because of this. There's two axes. There's the price axis, and there's the stability axis. It goes from handheld to smooth as if we go from handheld to a cheap tripod, the quality goes way up, but the price only goes up by a little. And that's why it's so good to have a cheap tripod. Then again, if we go from a cheap tripod to an expensive tripod, like a Manfrotto, the quality only goes up by a little bit, but the price takes a major hit. And then if we go from the expensive tripod up to a pro tripod, the quality doesn't really make a difference, but the price really goes up through the roof. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye!